Good evening, everyone, and happy Fresh Friday. This week I have an easy recipe. We're making a roasted red bell pepper sauce. This is going to be deliciously served up with some hummus and chopped up vegetables, but you can use this a number of ways, which I will tell you further in the video. We went out to Pope Family Farms this week, and let me tell you, it was a gorgeous drive. It was only about 30 minutes from Georgetown, and they have put out all of their fall decorations, treats, and pumpkins. If you want to hear more about our trip out there and the history of Pope Family Farms, be sure to check out our post at 11. Now let's get into the video. All I have done so far is heated up my oven to 500 degrees, yes, very hot, and we just added some whole washed red bell peppers. I just have two here. We're gonna add these in for 40 minutes, making sure that we churn them every 10 minutes so that each side gets a nice char. When we pull those out, we're immediately gonna put them into a bowl and cover it with cling film so that these can sweat it out. I let my peppers sweat for about 30 minutes. That's how long it took for these to cool off a bit and become manageable. We're just going to take off all of the skin and remove the seeds and the stem. Now you very easily could use roasted red peppers from the store. These are jarred, usually in the pickle section. But while we have an abundance of peppers in the state, I love to use fresh ones so that I can utilize all of the beautiful ingredients that we have. Now I know this is not a time saver for anyone, and not everyone has the time to do this or wants to, and that's absolutely okay. You're gonna have a delicious dip no matter which peppers you use. Once we've removed the skin, seeds, and stem, we are just going to add our peppers to a food processor. I'm just going to use a mini one here because we're not making a full recipe. So we're going to add in all of our peppers and give this a quick zhuzh just so we can break these up a little bit and make room for the other ingredients. We're going to add in some cashews, or you can add some walnuts or almonds. I just had some cashews on hand. We're gonna add one clove of peeled garlic, and then half of a lemon, making sure that we don't get any seeds in there because that's a little crunchy bit we don't need. We're going to add a little bit of olive oil on top and then give this a nice pulse. We want to see the consistency before we add an abundance of our olive oil because we don't want it too thin, but we also don't want it to be very chunky. So we're going to give this a good mix, and then we're going to make sure that we give it a taste and just see where our flavors are at. We're going to add in a little bit of kosher salt and then another drizzle of olive oil to thin this out. We're almost at the consistency we're looking for, but we want it just a little bit more dippable, if that makes sense. One more taste test just to make sure that the flavors are balanced and that I like the consistency, and it is good to go. To a small bowl, I'm going to add in some hummus. It is quite easy to make on your own, and maybe I will do a video on that in the future. But I just bought some at the store that I really like, and we are going to swirl this around. We're going to top it with our beautiful red pepper sauce, just a few scoops, and look how beautiful it is and vibrant. And for our veggie dippers, I have some cherry tomatoes, some snap peas, and some sliced cucumbers. You can use whatever vegetables you like. As you can see, this makes a great dip. It is quite delicious. But you can also use the roasted red pepper sauce as a substitute for marinara. If anyone is tomato free out there, this is a great substitute. Use this as a sauce for fried eggs, on sandwiches, really anything. I like to view it as a roasted red pepper pesto because it has basically all of the same ingredients except for the basil. I hope you all give this recipe a try. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to check out Pope Family Farms, and we will see you next week. Bye!